坦克进场.
I remember the tanks coming in at night, one after the other, rolling over anyone who stood in their way, smashing through the barricades. Their goal was to get to Tiananmen no matter what. And the no matter what were the ordinary people of Beijing. I stood on the balcony of Beijing Fandian. 我在北京饭店亮台上. 首先我在广场. 快到一点钟,凌晨一点, 我就回北京饭店, 继续看. So around 1 o'clock, I returned to the room I was renting at Beijing Fandian so I could keep watching. And all night I watched the dead and the wounded coming out of Tiananmen Square.
整个晚上我亲眼看到很多受伤的人, 还有死亡的人, 从天安门广场出来.
At first, they sent in ambulances, very brave ambulance drivers, because when they tried to drive into Tiananmen Square, the soldiers fired at them.
首先我看到救护车进天安门广场很勇敢的一些司机，为什么？因为他开救护车进去的时候，当兵的也开枪，也对他们开枪.
And when there weren't enough ambulances, the old guys who ride those sunlinche, those little pedicabs, they also went in, and they had no protection at all, and they pedaled right into Tiananmen Square.
救护车不够的时候，还有人登了那个三轮车，老头，都是老头登了自行车的三轮车，他也进广安，天安门广场，也救了一些受伤的人.
And when there weren't enough pedicabs to go around, because so many people were getting shot, ordinary people pushed their bicycles into Tiananmen Square, and I saw them coming out with a body flipped over their bicycle seat.
三轮车不够，我还看了骑自行车的老百姓，他就帮助一些受伤的人，或者可能死亡的人，他就把那个尸体放在他的座子上推出来。 第三个和最后的最深的影响是星期一晚上，不，星期一上午。今年正好六四是同一天，都是星期六晚上到星期天凌晨。然后星期一上午，我看了，我还在北京饭店工作，我的丈夫突然叫我，他说你应该出来，你应该看。后来我跑出来，在亮台上正好看。 那个tank man, 我亲眼看到了.
The days this year happened to coincide exactly with the same days in 1989. The troops came in on Saturday night, and the killing started Sunday morning, all day Sunday. And then on Monday morning, I was still in the Beijing hotel working, and my husband said to me, you better come out here onto the balcony and look at this. And there was the tank man. And I remember starting to cry because I had seen so many people die. And I thought, for sure he's going to get squashed right in front of my eyes.
我开始哭，因为我已经看了那么多人死了，我想那个坦克肯定要压死了这个青年。
But something interesting happened. The tanks didn't run him over. The tank driver went left, and then he went right, and then he went left, and each time the tank man jumped in front like a soccer goalie, tried to stop him, and even climbed up on top of the gun, whatever it's called, that gun, what's it called?
Turret.
Turret, thank you. The gun turret. And 那个青年不跑，那个坦克想绕着他走，他就不让，还爬上去。 And I started to cry, and I thought, I can't cry because I have to be the witness. I have to watch this. I have to see what's happening.
我开始哭，但是我不愿意哭，因为我要看得很清楚，我要报道给世界.
And then afterwards, I called my editor in Toronto, and I said, you won't believe what I saw. I don't know how I'm going to describe this with words. And she said, oh, don't worry. We have the pictures.
后来我给我编辑打了电话，我说我不知道怎么描写这个，但是我刚才看见了一个小英雄，一个人堆住了一大排的坦克。他说你放心好了，我们有照片。今天我们集中在这儿，为了纪念天安门广场的死亡。我们在这儿是因为他们在中国不能纪念。We come here today to remember the dead and the wounded of Tiananmen Square because in China itself, people cannot do this. 丁子霖教授，今天他的电话，家里电话被断了。Professor 丁子霖 had her phone lines cut to her home. She's not allowed to speak, 不让她说话，不让她接受记者采访。89年，他被他的工作被开除，他也被开除党籍。In 1989, she was fired from her job, and she was also kicked out of the Chinese Communist Party. Why? Because her son was killed at Tiananmen Square, and she wanted to tell everyone. She wasn't going to keep quiet. 为什么？是因为他有一个儿子，17岁的儿子，他在Tiananmen广场被枪毙了。Her son was 17 in 1989, and I guess today he would be 44 years old, and he would be looking after his mother. But he can't, of course. And Ding Zilin is virtually alone now because her husband died this past year, and her daughter also died of cancer. Ding Zilin 现在是一个人，因为今年她的丈夫死了，还有她的女儿也死了，癌症死的。But Ding Ziling is not alone, because we're with her, and we remember with her. Ding Ziling 教授不是一个人，因为我们今天在多伦多大学纪念Tiananmen的死亡和牺牲者。We will never forget Tiananmen. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Jen. Tyranny and suppression.All they fear are witnesses. So speak up. Thank you for being there. And thank you. We'll continue. Next, I'd like